हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम अगेन टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल सिविल एजु ऑनलाइन। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्वेश्चंस ऑफ बिल्डिंग मटेरियल्स एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन मैनेजमेंट। ओके, द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चंस ऑब्जेक्टिव्स दैट कैन बी आस्क्ड इन कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स दैट विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर ऑल कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स जीपीएससी आरपीएससी एंड सो ऑन। ओके, सो let's continue with the questions. First question is, stone helps in saving materials by reducing wall thickness from, the options given here are 30 to 20 mm, 20 to 10 centimeter, 20 to 10 mm and 30 to 20 centimeter. The options are so set accordingly in this question that there is confusion between interconversion of units, suppose in mm as well as centimeter. So such is the case in this case also. The answer comes out to be 30 to 20 centimeter. So how does this answer is achieved? You might be very well knowing, and if you don't know, the explanation is given here that the wall thickness of 30 centimeter is reduced to 20 centimeter by using stone blocks. Okay. After that, it is manufactured in the size of 30 into 20 into 15 centimeters. Okay, so it weighs 18 kg. Okay, so dimensions are 30 into 20 into 15. So the answer comes out to be option D. Thereafter, next question is, FRP stands for. Okay, this is a very famous thing. You might be very well knowing that FRP stands for fiber reinforced polymer. Okay, next question, in dash cement mortar is reinforced with wire meshes, so obviously ferro cement. Thereafter next question is, fiber reinforced concrete is used in, the options given are pavements, foundations, slabs, beam. Okay, so you very well know correct answer is generally it is used in pavements. Okay, so the explanation it is given as it is here that it has a superior fatigue, crack as well as impact resistance, due to which the durability is high, and due to this durability it is more used in pavements, airfields, etc. Okay. Thereafter, next question is, concrete hollow blocks has the following characteristics. So the options given are, it is has less thermal insulation, then it is costly, it is fast construction, decreases the floor area. So the correct answer is, as you know, option C, fast construction. Because the standard size of hollow brick is usually 39 into 19 into 30 centimeters, compared to the standard size of brick, which is 19 cross 9 cross 9 centimeters. Units also you have to remember correctly, centimeters. So due to this difference in size, obviously one brick has more dimension than one standard brick, so it will be faster construction. Okay, that is its use. Thereafter, next question is, dash are widely used in rural areas for construction of walls. So the correct answer would be stabilized mud blocks. You must have also seen stabilized mud blocks, which are made up of some small brick species as well as mud blocks. They are kind of bricks, not exactly bricks, but they are kind of bricks made up of mud. Okay. Thereafter, next question is, fluoro gypsum used in super sulfated cement or as binding agents is a waste product of manufacturers of what? So the correct answer is obviously fluoro gypsum. So it is a waste product of hydrofluoric acid. Okay, Thereafter, next question is, which of the following below roofing materials is most cost effective? So in terms of roofing materials, obviously metal is most cost effective. That's why it is used in rural areas as well as some slum or slum localities and all that. They have metal as the Thereafter, what does grade 33 cement indicate? The options are, the correct answer will be option D. Compressive strength is 33 Newton per mm square. Okay. Thereafter, ordinary Portland cement has been classified into how many grades? The answer is 3 grades. And what are those three grades? Those three grades are grade 33, grade 43 and grade 53. These are the usual standard grades as per IS 269. Okay. This code was also revised in 1991, just for your information. Thereafter, next option is, question is, sorry, grade 43 OPC is widely used for, okay. So grade 43 is a medium, okay. Grade 33 is low strength, grade 53 is bit highest strength, and 43 is medium in this case. So generally highest strength is used for high rise building, so grade 53 for high rise building. And then grade 43 has a bit higher strength than 33, as I said, okay. So it is used for finishing works, grade 33. So for all the other works, grade 43 is used, okay. So grade 33 is mostly only used for finishing works under normal conditions, and grade 53 is used for high-rise buildings. So the answer in this case comes out to be house construction. Thereafter, next question is, after how many days is the strength of cement tested and graded according to the result? So as you know very well, 28 days, okay, no need for explanation in this case. Thereafter, next question is, compressive strength of ordinary Portland cement increases with time. So is it a true statement or a false statement? Obviously it is a true statement, because the strength which we achieve is not 100% strength, okay. So as and when the time increases, even after 28 days, the strength will increase with the time. Thereafter, next question is, grade 43 OPC shall be rejected if it remains bulk storage in factory for dash. So the correct answer is more than 6 months. So if it remains for more than 6 months, then it should be rejected, because time period of more than 3 months is for cement bags. See, such question is generally asked because of this doubt. Some people may answer 3 months, some people may answer 6 months, but the correct answer is 6 months, because sorry, this time period 3 months is for cement bags to be with vendors, okay. But after 3 months, maximum after 3 months, it should be sold. So after, for the ultimate, from the when it is made in factory, so cement will be stored for 6 months and rejected if it does not meet the corresponding requirements or the required requirements, okay. Thereafter, next question is, the ratio of percentage of alumina to iron oxide in OPC 43 grade is, the answer comes out to be option B, 0.66, because according to IS 8112 2013, in which table 2.3.5 states that sulfur, total sulfur content 0.1 is the chloride content and 0.05 is the alkali content, okay. So out of 3.5, if you calculate 3.5 and 0.15. Okay, that is the total sulfur content, this is chloride content and alkali content. So from that, if you calculate and using other data that are given in table 2, so answer comes out to be 0.66. So remaining questions we will be continuing in our next video. So please stay tuned, and if you have not subscribed our channel, please subscribe it. Thank you everybody. Thank you for watching our video.